girl, how's it going?
Oh, good. How are you?
I'm doing good. Hey, I saw you at the grocery store yesterday. How are you and Joseph doing?
Oh, super great. We just love each other so much, and I'm so glad that we're in this relationship.
Yeah, you guys are really cute together. I noticed, though, that he's kind of rude at the grocery store. Is everything okay? He was, like, raising his voice and kind of mad. Are you guys okay, or...?
Yeah, we're great. I was taking long, and so he was just getting kind of frustrated that I was taking so long, but it's totally fine. Don't even worry about it.
As witnesses to a domestic violence issue, we can recognize many red flags that the victim may have with their significant other. The first one of those would be that the victim's significant other has a temper issue and may or may not result out in physical outbreaks to the victim.
Well, I'm glad you guys are doing good. Me and some of the girls are going to go to the lake this weekend. Do you want to come?
I don't know if I can. I would have to check with Joseph first. He likes it when we do things together.
Another red flag that we can notice that can empower us as witnesses is recognizing that the victim's significant other is over-controlling and desires to have know where the victim is at all times.
All right. Well, how's your classes going? How's the schools for you?
You know, they're super great, but, you know, I have to go. Joseph just texted me, and he wants me to be back home to do homework together, so I think I'll have to talk to you later.
Oh, okay. Have a good day.
Yeah.
As we recognize these red flags, we truly can be a friend and help others when they are domestic violence.